Hi, I'm Dave Ford. I'm a manufacturer's representative. One of the products that I represent is American Hakko products. And what we're here to talk about today is the Hakko FM-203. The FM-203 is a two-channel station that has the ability to handle 270-watt hand pieces at different temperatures at the same time. So it's a little bit of space saving on the workbench, but it also gives you the ability now to do some other things also. But let's just talk about the standard soldering procedure with this. We use the FM-2027 as the standard 70-watt handpiece, and it uses the T15 series tips along with a grip assembly. Plug those two together, and it plugs into the handpiece, and there we go, we're ready to go. Okay, so we turn the station on, and we've got a 70-watt handpiece that's plugged into the right channel here, and you'll notice that we have silk screens on the two different channels here, and the reason for that is a lot of people are wondering why get an FM-203 instead of two FX-951s. The reason for that would be is that having a larger transformer in the FM-203, we have the ability to power some higher-end, more thermal-challenging hand pieces, such as our hot tweezer arrays, our FM-2024-21 desolder module, and also our relatively new 140-watt hand piece, which is our FM-2030. The FM-2030, when it's plugged into this side, is going to require all the power to be used for that particular handpiece. You can switch back and forth between the two, but you can't run two simultaneously. It does give you the ability to use that high wattage handpiece, though, to overcome a great thermal ground plane. Many of the same features as the FX-951. We have a card key lockout feature here, and we have the ability to change temperatures that way. Take the card key away, and then the operator can't change the temperature and change your process. So there's some shop floor security as far as that goes. The handpiece itself, when it's powered, you'll see that there's a light on here that indicates we are sending power. If for some reason we didn't have the tip plugged in all the way, or we didn't have the handpiece plugged in correctly, it will give us an alarm and let us know that. It wouldn't send heat to the tip, obviously, because you don't have a connection. The holder itself has a micro switch in the back, so that when we put the handpiece in, we can have a cord that goes between here and here. It does come with the station, and it will go into sleep mode, which is a good feature for saving the life of the tips themselves. We also use our 599 instead of a wet sponge as a standard with this station, because we're not thermal cycling the tip when we clean it, and we also get some mechanical action for lead-free alloys. And that gives you the ability to take some oxidation off the tip, and reduce the amount of pitting that occurs and allow the tip to wet correctly. So just one other thing that I want to mention is that with these different tools that we have on here, there's going to be significant differences in the mass of the tips that we're heating up. And in order to meet the industry standards for that, we have to have intelligence in the microprocessor to be able to do an offset in the background for what the different requirements are, based on whether it's a hot tweezer or if it's a high wattage handpiece or a desoldering iron for that matter. So when you plug the handpiece into the station, the microprocessor identifies what handpiece it is, and it goes into the offset mode for that. And that allows us to be able to meet the industry standards without having a calibration point for the user anywhere on the station.